How you like that?
Huh? I guess it's your lucky day, boy.
Welcome back to Recap IT. Today we are going to recap a 2018 drama thriller movie titled Traffic. A couple's romantic holiday turns into a nightmare when a gang of bikers starts harassing them. The pair is desperately trying to find a way out as the gang is hell-bent on killing them. But before we begin, please consider subscribing to this channel. Now, without wasting any further time, let's begin, shall we? A young woman dances in a nightclub in the beginning of the film. When she is contacted by a man, she agrees to accompany him. Later, she is kidnapped and stashed away in a trailer. Brea is introduced in the following scene. She works as a reporter for the Sacramento Post. She is enraged to learn that a rival journalist is covering a major scandal story that she had been working on for months. Brea approaches her supervisor, Carl, who dismisses her story as a gimmick. Brea celebrates her birthday with her boyfriend John and their friends Darren and Malia at a restaurant. Darren spoils John's entire surprise for Brea, in which he planned to take her on a romantic retreat in the California mountains. The ladies then proceed to the restroom, where Brea believes John will propose, but she claims she is not prepared. The next day, John arrives at Brea's house and presents her with a car he created in his shop before they depart on their trip. They pull off to a petrol station, where Brea enters the restroom and encounters Kara, a scared-looking woman. Sure seems a lot like the 4th of July, she tells Brea, as a thug steps in and orders Kara to speed up. Another biker approaches John outside the station, interrogating him about his automobile and asking bigoted questions like if he's a ball player or if he works in the prison auto shop. The biker spits on his car after John assures him he doesn't want trouble, and John replies by striking him in the face. As his friends encircle John, the biker pulls out a knife, but Sheriff Martin intervenes and keeps the bikers at bay. Brea and John exit the station. One of the bikes starts following John and Brea down the road. John accelerates and then brakes, causing the rider to swerve off the road and down a hill. Back at the station, Red, the biker's leader, chastises his thugs for attracting attention and failing to apprehend Brea. When the couple arrives at their holiday home, they spend the afternoon in the pool together. Darren and Malia surprise them with an unannounced visit, despite Darren convincing Malia that John was cool with it, obviously he isn't. The couple continues to hang out until Darren receives a phone call informing him that an athlete he represents has been arrested. To ease himself, he uses cocaine. Brea's bag then makes a ringing sound, which they hear. She discovers a satellite phone in her suitcase and realizes it was slid into her bag by Kara. All of them advise her to try a different passcode. Brea considers Kara's 4th of July remark and deduces that it's a passcode. It worked, and the phone is unlocked. They discover hundreds of photographs of mistreated women posing for advertisements, alerting the couples to the fact that they are involved in a human trafficking ring. Brea decides to contact the cops, but Darren deters her by pointing out that this is a business. People with a lot of clout stay here. He does not want the location to be publicized. Brea insisted that they contact the authorities. Darren decides to reveal that John and Malia had a relationship long before they met Brea or Darren. Malia was enraged at Darren's behavior and stormed out the door, never to return. John and Brea reapply their makeup and vow to tell one another everything from now on. A knock comes at the door a few moments later. Kara is present when Brea answers, and she asks for her phone back. Even when Kara yells for the phone back, Brea offers to assist. When John, Brea, and Darren try to catch up with her, Red and the motorcyclist switch on their headlights. Kara rushes up to Red and tells him she hasn't received her phone, and he shoots her in the head. The three dash back into the house, where Darren orders them to hand over the phone. He even pulls out a revolver to get Brea to hand it over. He goes outside to return the phone till he notices Malia's luggage and realizes the motorcyclists are in possession of her. He tries to broker a deal with Red to return the phone in exchange for Malia, but Red is aware that the phone has been opened and that they have been hacked. Darren tries to draw his gun on them, but the bikers repeatedly knife him before Red shoots him in the head. While being pursued by the motorcyclists, John and Brea flee the house through the garage. The pair flees into the woods, where they are pursued by the prejudiced biker from earlier. He attacks John with a knife, but Brea whacks him in the face with a large branch before John obtains the knife and stabs him. The duo dashes to an older gentleman's cabin. He invites them in so they can use the phone, and Brea requests to use the computer so she can send a message to Carl with the photos of the exploited women. Unfortunately, another biker arrives and kills the elder man before going after the pair. Breya's communication is intercepted and the computer is destroyed. Before Breya stabs him in the back, the biker fights John and shoots him in the side. John snatches the biker's gun and shoots him in the head, but his wound is fatal. Before dying, he informs Breya that he obtained the biker's car keys and proclaims his love for her. Breya later discovers an engagement ring that John intended to propose with and wears it in his honor. Breya runs outside to try to start the automobile, but she is discovered by Red and the remaining motorcyclist. Marn, who had been summoned by John, arrives with a deputy before they can take her. Marn, on the other hand, turns out to be a part of the drug trafficking ring, as she proves by shooting and killing the deputy. She chastises Red and the biker for mistreating the girls as products and for failing to delete the evidence from the phone. Breya is sedated and taken away. Breya awakens alongside the other trafficked women, including Malia, at a secret location. Breya reveals that John and Darren are no longer alive. Red and his henchmen walk in. He informs Breya that he will be keeping her to himself. Breya responds by stabbing him in the neck with a nail before bludgeoning him to death. The biker attacks Breya, but Malia's sedative poisons him. Breya vows to return for Malia before seeking assistance. Breya emerges from the trees and finds herself in the vicinity of yet another gas station. She walks there in full view of the other customers, who can see how battered she is. She walks into the store and asks the clerk to contact the cops. Breya takes a phone from the desk and dials Carl's number for assistance. Martin arrives for Breya after dusk. She enters the store in order to apprehend her. Breya inquires about Marn's pride in profiting from the trafficking of women. Everything is trafficked, Marn says, and she is only a part of it. Marn handcuffs Breya and leads her outside, only to be met by a swarm of cops. Marn is apprehended, and the exploited ladies are rescued by the cops. Breya returns to work in the closing scene in Sacramento, where Carl informs her that the trafficking ring bust will be great news everywhere, but that the people implicated would most certainly go for Breya. She merely says, "Let them come," and walks away. And this is where the movie comes to an end. I hope you enjoyed it, as always until next time.